Oops. A 65-million-mile journey to Mars starts tomorrow, and NASA will be launching its Perseverance rover from Cape Canaveral.
It's so exciting. The rover will look for preview signs of live testing, new technology, and a whole lot more. Joining us now to talk about this historic mission is NASA Administrator Jim Reuter. Good morning, Jim.
Jim, good morning.
Good morning.
So tell
us. It's really early for you.
It's way too early.
So tell us about tomorrow's mission to Mars and what makes it different from previous trips.
Yeah, we're really excited about this mission to Mars. It'll be our ninth lander mission to Mars and the fifth rover. What makes this one really special is it's got the most sophisticated instruments of any rover that we've had, and it's going to do two key things. It'll search for former life on the planet. 3.5 billion years ago at this Jezero crater where we're landing, it was a river delta, and so it's a great area that potentially could have had life, and we'll look for signatures there. And also there's instruments on board to help us prepare for future missions, including humans.
All right, Jim, you have to have the coolest job on Earth, really. And I mean, no pun intended.
Yeah.
Where is Perseverance going to land, and how much of the planet, of course, will it explore? I know you talked about it.
Yeah, it'll land in the Jezero crater, which is a key crater that was a former riverbed, basically, for a river delta. And it will go around that area in there. The crater itself is 28 miles in diameter, or 28 miles wide, and it'll cover a good portion of that, but just stay in that general vicinity.
And Jim, of course, NASA is planning and hoping to send an astronaut to Mars someday. Could this mission help with that?
It sure can. There's a lot of instruments on board that will really help us understand how to live and operate in Mars. The first thing is a technology that we call terrain relative navigation. It's going to be key to supporting this mission and getting to the right place because it's got a camera on it, and it will use a database of places, and so look for a place that's safe to land. And so that's going to be absolutely critical when we have people there. Another technology that's on board is one that we call MOXIE. It's an oxygen generator. The Mars atmosphere is about 95% carbon dioxide, and will generate oxygen from that atmosphere.
All right, and with a mission now so big as this, it always comes with challenges. What are some of the biggest challenges for a mission?
Yeah, this mission has a lot of interesting challenges that goes through it. First of all, the launch itself is never a given, but we're looking forward to that tomorrow. Then it's $65 million journey. And then once you get there, then the really hard part goes. The Mars atmosphere is kind of an anti-Goldilocks. It is too thin to really help you slow down when you're trying to enter, and it's not thick enough to help you slow down, and it's too thick that it will cause some heating. And so, so a key part of that is just how do we enter and land on the planet.
Now, Jim, how can people watch this incredible mission and stay updated with the journey to Mars?
Yes. The launch tomorrow is scheduled for 7:50 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. There's a two-hour launch window. If you want to watch it, then by all means go to nasa.gov/live, and they start broadcasting, I believe, around 7 a.m. Eastern Time.
All right, Jim, thank you so much. It's good to see you and glad to have you on.
Yes.
It's great to be here. Thank you.
Congratulations, too, on this
mission.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. We're excited.